So let's start from, we have ended with the lymphatic system. So let's see what happens in the lymphatic system. Okay. You can see that the liquid portion in the blood with nutrients that flows in the capillary, this is called as a fluid tissue. And this fluid tissue is parallel with the venous system. As I told you, it collects tissues, and from tissues, it is transported to the venous system. This we have already completed. We are just recapitulating it. And as I told you, Latin meaning of lymph is water. It is full of water and you don't find any solid particles, whereas blood contains solid and liquid particles both. And all those solid corpuscles, I told you, white blood corpuscles, red blood corpuscles, thrombocytes, all these makes a blood, you know, takes care of your lymphatic system. So now, as you know, that muscles, they are attached to the skeleton and it acts as a pumps, they contract, and when the values are present in the lymphatic vessels and veins, stop the reverse flow of blood. This is the system of our lymphatic system circulation. And now let us see how it has been evolved. If you want to lead your daily normal life, we need several items such as food, grains, vegetables, fruits, clothes, medicines, fuel, electricity, everything. You know, all these are energy. So if you look at grains, fruits, vegetables, clothes, most of them are organic, and there are inorganic also. So if you look at animal like amoeba, amoeba is called, you know, the movement. You can see the movement which amoeba is showing right now. And it is called as a Brownian movement. This movement which you were seeing earlier, that was called as a Brownian movement because of the nutrients and oxygen that is distributed through the protoplasm. This fluid-like substance, can you all see this amoeba? And the fluid-like substance inside it?
Yes, ma'am.
So, you know, this...
Yes, ma'am, you can see.
Yeah. So, why was it moving like that, amoeba? So that it can thoroughly distribute all the nutrients to all parts of the body. And this intercellular transportation system is present in unicellular animals and has been retained even in multicellular big organisms like human beings, lion, elephant, and all. And the protoplasm of any cell in our body is mobile. What do you mean by mobile? And this, what do you mean by mobile means?
Connected.
Yes?
Connected.
Mobile, you say that the phone, you have got a mobile phone, or you are on a you are mobile. You see things that are mobile. What do you mean by mobile things or in the station things? Mobile means? Anybody can guess and tell me. You say you have got, what do you do? How do you reach from one place to other? By moving. So the word mobile comes from movement. So we see that this protoplasm is moving throughout the body, and every cell is connected. Through the cells, this protoplasm reaches, and the food is distributed to all parts of the body through protoplasm. And the protoplasm of any cells, you just see when you look at the complicated multicellular organisms, the mammals, there also the transportation takes place through protoplasm of each cell. And the protozoans like the sponges, seawater, they are natural. Through natural water current, most of the time this takes place. Whereas the sponges create their own current by beating the flagella. flagella are in the earlier classes also you have read it that it is these are the flagellas which helps in the movement. They are the hair like structures, and with this movement these animals cinadrians and the sponges, paramecium, chlamydomonas, their movement takes place by these hair like structures called cilia. So this is how the cilia also helps in the proper distribution. And in hydra, jellyfish, they have the developed blind sac-like gastrovascular cavities, and that functions for the digestion and transportation of the nutrients. You can see a very clear, well-defined gastrovascular cavity in organisms like jellyfish and hydra. And this its function is to distribute nutrients properly to all parts of the body through this protoplasm. So the protoplasm moves, not the entire cell moves. The protoplasm is a fluid that moves in the body. And if you look at platyhelminthes, what happens? Platyhelminthes is this or these organism, tapeworms and all, and they have got a branched supplies of digested food to all the cells directly. So you can just see how the digestive system is evolving and upgrading from one animal to another, from unicellular to multicellular organisms. And they have got a well-defined excretory system also that collects waste from each cell individual. And these organisms, most of the body is occupied by the digestive and excretory system. So any doubts, anything you would like to, any questions, or you all are clear, we can move ahead. Yes, Alina Begum, switch on your camera, Aisha and Alina Begum. Yes.
Yeah, ma'am.
We can proceed. Okay. What do you mean by excretory system? Yes, excretion means? Nobody is answering. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
So what do you mean by excretion? Am I not clear?
Clear, ma'am. Your voice is clear.
Please answer. I should be knowing whether you're understanding it or not. Yes, yes, Sapi, are yes. You able to understand?
Yes,
show me the thumbs up at least. How will I know whether you're understanding or not? Only Sapi has understood. Arbaz, yes, good. What about Aisha, Alina, girls? You have understood. Okay, thank you so much. So now let's proceed further. And you look at this, these are annelids, you call leeches. Generally, you see these leech into your bathrooms and people say that it sucks your blood. We have to be careful with them. So they come under the category of annelids. And orthopods, what is the meaning of orthopod? Orthopods are again a Greek and Latin word. Orth means joint, okay? Pod means legs. So the animals that have got jointed legs, they are called as orthopods. And orthopods are like cockroaches, you see, and any organisms that have got this joint, grasshopper, they are all orthopods. And even they have got a developed pulsatile organ to pump the blood. And they have also got the heart and all the evolved. It's not as highly evolved as mammalians, but even it has got a clear transportation system evolved among orthopods. So can anybody repeat what do you mean by orthopods?
Which have legs jointed.
Joint legs, very good. Remember that orthopedics is also the doctors. We go generally to the orthopedics. They do the treatment for the bones and joints. So we call them orthopedics. Yes. So with that, you can remember, arth is joint and podia is for legs. So these orthopods are the animals that have got joint legs with joints. So in them, you can see how the blood tissue is flowing, and it directly supplies all the nutrients to the tissues. What are tissues? Yes, what are tissues?
Tissues means that between the muscles.
Yes. What are tissues?
Tissues connected muscles.
Aisha and Alina, why girls are not at all participative? If you're not understanding, you can ask questions. I told you a group of cells performing same function forms tissues, and group of tissues forms an organ. So that's how the oxygen is directed by respiratory system. So now you can see that the other type of transportation system, the blood takes the responsibility of delivering materials that flow in the blood vessels, and it is called as a closed type of circulatory system. So these closed type of circulatory systems you can see in annelids, echinoderms, cephalopods, example mollusks and higher animals. So these all have got closed circulatory system. So now you remember this, and tomorrow we'll continue. Let's join for the assembly. So